So, but with the Jyoti proved that, so by her passion and she could communicate very excellently, that is one of the, one of the criteria which we are going to judge the teachers. So, the content part, the pedagogy part and the communicative skills, where Jyoti, she is able to speak very fluently. Yeah, so that's and that's my observation. So there is no hurdle, even if you are from Telugu medium also, and most of us are from Telugu medium also. Commonly we complain that, so I've got the background of a Telugu medium. So, but when Jyoti could do, so I most of my friends, they can also do that. But it's only a question of passion. Your interest is very much important.
Okay. Yeah. Madam, do you remember any particular pedagogy adopted by a teacher? Can you name one the teacher, one who has done anything? Do you remember anyone particularly? You also witnessed the seminar in Warangal. Anybody?
Warangal Bhadrakali.
Bhadrakali, okay.
Bhadrakali, she's very good in content part.
Yes.
She's a lecturer. But she is very good in her communication skills, and she has elicited answers from the students, and she has given very good content to the students.
Okay.
That I liked that.
Right. And also when you talk to Warangal, I think one resource teacher, music teacher.
Yes. Oh, wonderful. She is wonderful.
Yeah.
Really.
Her name is Akhilandeshwari.
Akhilandeshwari.
She is a CRT in music.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We are very, very happy to see the.
So, I've got, two more experience to share with you.
Yeah.
So
madam, just please come, continue, madam. Yeah, Akhilandeshwari. Yeah.
Akhilandeshwari. Yeah. She's Hindustani music and Shastriya Sangeetam, everything. And local songs also she sung. And very nice. We are really astonished, and her communication skills are good.
Yes,
astonishingly.
Yes,
usually in special teachers, we won't see that
such communication skills.
Her communication skills are very good.
Yes.
She is really very good. Fantastic.
Okay. And I think I also witnessed her and her nuance of knowledge, the different nuance of Western music also. She was good at it, and she sang a beautiful Western song. And also the way she presented with a lot of enthusiasm and activeness, I think she has prepared her. She deserves special kudos from the society as far as presentation is concerned. Now, sir, do you want to add to this some of the teachers who have done extremely well?
Yeah, it, not only the subject teachers, the junior lecturers, PGTs, TGTs. Yeah, as you said, Akhilandeshwari, music teacher. Yeah, I wanted to share with the best presentations of the special teacher, Neeraja Reddy, the physical director of Suddapalli.
Yeah.
Suddapalli. She gave a very good, excellent presentation, very good communicative skills without any, first time, that is the first experience.
Yes.
Yeah, first, the PowerPoint presentation, the participation in the seminar also.
Yeah.
The other teacher, the Jayashila, a librarian of the Isnapur, Medak district also, she gave a very good, wonderful presentation. Even the principal's part, Shobharani, the principal of Thadkol. Thadkol. Yes. There are so many, presentations. Wherever we have impressed with the presentation of the principals also, we are sharing with you. Their best presentations are there. And the special teachers also, it's not only the dominated by the PGT, TGTs. Even special teachers also, they gave very good presentations. And the music teachers also. So, it's an inspiring stories for the most of the special teachers also. Even they can also do much better in the NQP seminars.
So, to sum it up, whatever you say, you were impressed, or we were impressed, impressed by the presentation in terms of their methodology, their pedagogy, and their presentation skills. Right. So, presentation skill is very important.
Yeah.
The moment you have, it doesn't matter whether you have so much content or not. Of course, content is important, but I feel that your presentation is very, very important. The way you present your content is very important, so that there is continuous effort, continuous interest from the students, and that interest is sustained in the classroom. That's important.
Yeah.
I think we were all impressed by the persons, whether it is a principal, whether it's a PD, whether it's a music teacher.
Yeah.
We were impressed by their presentation.
Yeah.
They were very pleasant. They all had that smile.
Very
I would say,
skills.
Yeah, they have very good communication skills, and they are very confident.
Yeah.
They were not tensed. And by the way, there were some teachers who were tensed. And in fact, I was remarking that some of them were also preparing for the MCET 3. So, but maybe that's the reason. Maybe that first, I think that's first time they are presenting, and they viewed the complete seminar as a monster, an unknown monster. They think that a monster is going to devour them, to swallow them. So, but it didn't happen. So at the end, I heard some of the teachers remarking, "Ah, after all this, at the end of the seminar,
yes,
they were so relaxed, and they said, 'Abba, intena.' So they said that way. That means they are fearing the unknown. Probably they did not read the Ten Commandments.
Yeah. So, fear the unknown.
Yeah, they should. I think the teachers, all those who are tense, they should read the Ten Commandments and say, 'Never fear the unknown.'" Sir, to both of you, I wanted to remark on this my question. Like, we have given the topic, it is not a topic out of their textbook. It is something like out of thinking out of the box questions we ask them. Do you think that they at the end they rounded up their question and did they come to the question part of it? That's my question is, did they really touch the topic at the end of the seminar? First to you.
Yeah. So, frankly, no.
No. Okay.
Yeah, most of them, there was no meaningful conclusions.
Uh-huh.
So, the what is the importance of the topic and how its relevance with their day-to-day life. And they never conclude, never asked any question at the end of the their presentation also.
Okay.
Yeah.
Right, madam.
I agree with him. That question is not related to their seminar. They are telling something and the question is different.
Different, okay. Different. So, what is the reason you think the why it happened like that? Why it has happened like that?
I think they didn't go into the depth of the question and related to the textbook. They should relate the question to the textbook. So, that they have not done.
So, yeah, what I feel that the pedagogy, that's very, very important, the methodology. So, they have not planned their that 15 minutes properly. So, what I feel that and a lot of rehearsal is also very much required before giving a presentation, and also and how to conclude a lesson, how to conclude that particular 15 minutes is also very, very important, and most of them they have not planned for their conclusion of the topic.
Okay.
They have not planned for the conclusion, how to conclude the topic.
Okay. I think
they have to sum up or they have to ask a question to the student also. They can take the help of the students also. Their students can also sum up the topic, what they have learned.
Yeah, I think to sum up what they said, I think the topic is given to the teachers, but they did not really go into the topic and they did not give a thought to the topic. That means logical conclusion of the topic was not given.
Yeah.
So, little bit of logical conclusion, I think it will go a long way. I appeal to all the teachers who are listening to us today. Whenever a topic is given to you, please read through the questions. Slightly, sometimes it's a tricky question, a very, very simple question. If you read the textbook, if you read the chapter, you will find the answer. Please think out of the box. It's called lateral thinking. And try to conclude that topic in a logical way at the end of the seminar. Do you agree with me, sir?
Yes. Yes.
Yes.
Yes. That's true.
I agree with you.
Okay. And again, coming back to the presentation part of your teachers, what is the most obvious mistake they made in presentation is concerned? Some of the teachers, madam, to you. What is very obvious? It is very obvious. That's a mistake is very obvious. What is the
Students participation is not there. They are neglecting the students.
They are neglecting
the
students.
More content they are giving, but activities are not there, and they are not involving students.
Okay.
That I observe.
You observed that. Sir, your observation.
Yeah. So, it is a kind of content oriented presentation, whatever the content that they have prepared. So, they wanted to deliver that. So, they wanted to present that, and they have not concentrated on the, as madam told the, and so there is no interaction, no participation. And and they have not taken the students along with them while teaching, presenting the topic.
Okay.
Yeah. So, the, whatever the content that they have prepared, they have to give a presentation.
That's all.
And depended on the PPTs.
So, they were all concentrating on the topic
and present the topic to the audience.
Yes. Somehow they wanted to get rid of that 15 minutes. I mean, that's the impression they give. Madam, what is their body language? Did you like some of the teachers' body language, or how is the percentage of body language they used?
It's very poor, I think.
Okay.
Body language, they are not concentrating on that.
Body language. Yes. So, what should be a body language of an effective teacher?
there should be a smile on their face. That is very much important. There should be a smile on their face.
Okay.
And with actions, if a deaf person listens to her, they should be able to they know what she is telling.
Yeah.
So for that, the teachers they should confine to only the podium, but they should use their hands and their facial expressions. All this should be there.
Okay, it is like, you know, without a body language or without listening to them, it is like watching a black and white silent movie, right? In 60s, they had a silent movie watching. There is only a straight face, straight jacketed, they call it straight jacketed presentation by the teachers. I think body language of the teachers is also very important. By looking at the teacher, even we also, we want to listen to a lecture. After 2 minutes, 3 minutes, we become boring because there is no voice modulation. Part of body language, yes. There is no body, no voice modulation. The same tone, face expression. You want to add to that something, sir?
Yeah. So, as madam told, the body language, most of them they confine to the podium only. No participation from the students. No interaction. They never asked questions. Yeah, this is the only one. Whatever we share, the similar things that we have been sharing with you.
Okay.
So it's very serious presentation. No smile on the face of the teachers. Yeah, most of them, and they never asked questions. They never moved from the positions, from the platform location, podium location. Yeah, these are the observations. They have to mingle, interact. So they can sing, they can dance. Even the Telugu teachers, those who gave a presentation of the Telugu poems also, very mundane way of, very serious way of presenting those poems also. And there is no melody also in the poems that they sang.
Okay. So now, then the next $1 billion question to both of you is, what encouragement or what reward the teachers who have done excellently well, that is say above 80%. So for convenience sake, we are making it as 80% or 60% because we need to categorize them.
Yeah.
So let's call it the outstanding teachers. Is the society going to reward them?
Yes.
If yes, in what way?
Yeah.
Definitely, society is going to reward them by giving them a commendation letter.
Okay.
And also a small token of memory to them.
Oh my.
Definitely, we are planning that. We'll definitely give them.
Sir, anything else?
Yeah, and more than that, also even sir wanted to send them to the best institutions, and he wanted to. Give gifts to them and send them to the best institutions where the best practices are followed also.
Yeah.
And a trip to abroad also.
The best institution means out of the state. Yeah, it can be North India, it can be South India, it can be Eastern India, anywhere.
Yeah.
Okay.
And he wanted to give preference to the teachers in their transfers also. Today, it has been written in the Hindu newspaper at 4th page.
Yeah.
Yeah. About the NQP, what kind of awards that they are going to get, the best presenters, they will be the mentor teachers for the needs improvement category teachers also.
Yeah.
So they will be given a privilege of the mentoring the teachers, junior teachers.
Very good.
And for that, they will also get a remuneration for that also.
Okay. Now, when you talk about mentor teacher, I just wanted to have a common doubt which is expressed by the teachers.
Yeah.
So what do you mean by mentorship and mentee and mentors? So in what way the mentee? It means the teachers who is getting mentored is benefited from the mentor.
Yeah. So these mentor teachers, those whom we have already identified, they are there in the districts also, in each and every subject teachers, and we have got the mentor teachers also. And through the various taking the information from the principals and the DCOs, and we found them in the panel inspections also, and we have got mentor teachers. We have got a list of mentor teachers. These the teachers, those who could not do present very well, better way. So these mentees will be sent to that particular teacher, mentor teacher. There they will be observing the classes of the mentor teacher, and the routine, the daily the routine of the teacher will be observed. The kind of the teaching diaries, the teaching notes, the maintained by the teachers will be observed. They'll be sitting in the class of the mentor teacher, and they'll be observing. And they will also get a chance for giving a presentation in that particular school also.
Okay.
The mentor teacher will train the mentees in such a way that after 1 week, spending 1 week in that particular school, after taking the mentorship, and they have to give a presentation in that particular school.
Okay.
Yeah.
Ma'am, it's a question to you. How do you find yourself as a mentee? That means I am your mentor. and you are sent to me to be mentored under me. So as a teacher, if you are a mentee, how do you feel it?
I'll be very happy because
someone
is there to clear my doubts.
Okay.
And learn new methods and new techniques.
Yeah.
And new pedagogy.
Yeah.
So I'll be very happy. I can clear my doubts. I can practice more and more. Practice makes a man perfect.
Okay.
So I can practice more and more. In that way, I'll be benefited in my profession.
Okay.
So I'll be very happy.
Yeah. So you are not afraid that you are branded as a mentee and you don't know anything.
No, never.
You are not afraid.
No one is perfect.
No one is perfect. Yeah. I think the
teacher. Teacher is always a learner.
Yeah, I think the teachers who are listening to us has to listen to what madam said. She says, as a mentee, she feels like a learner. She can learn new things from the mentor.
Yeah.
I hope.
Question.
Yeah.
Okay.
Hello.
Sir, good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
Sir, I am Narasimha, Principal Ibrahimpatnam, sir.
Ah, sir, Narasimha, sir. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, sir. Lakshmi, sir. Good afternoon, sir.
Yeah, good afternoon, Narasimha.
After much waiting on screen, we are able to watch you, sir.
Okay.
Sir,
thank you.
And NQP.
Yeah.
Our staff wants to interact with you, sir.
Yeah, they are welcome,
even
please.
Even though it is excellent program introduced by our secretary, sir. It is an excellent program and it is innovative also.
Okay.
So, our staff wants to interact with you, sir, one of our senior JL.
Okay,
yeah, first
please.
Of all, Narasimha.
Can I hand over it to me, sir?
Yeah, Narasimha.
Sir.
Okay, please ask question.
Sir.
Please ask question.
Good evening, sir. Good evening, sir.
Yeah, good evening.
I am Arjuna.
Yeah, Arjuna. Good evening.
Sir. Hi. One more doubt, sir.
Okay, Arjuna. Please go ahead.
How can this, sir?
Hello.
We are welcome to NQP, sir. But we have a lot of doubts.
Okay.
Sir, how can we test or judge the performance of a teacher within just 15 minutes, sir? One doubt.
Yeah.
And another one is, if a teacher who gets above 80% of marks in NQP may fail to get the required percentage of results in the public examination, then what will you do? Will you exempt the teacher from Rule 28 or not? Sir, give please clarity, sir.
So, we never thought of this, Rule 28 part. Even our secretary is also against the Rule 28 also. Yeah, but the issue is, so Arjun is a very expensive teacher. Consistently, he is getting 90%, 95% above results in his subject. And not only case of Arjun, also the teacher, whoever is so passionate, I am very confident that they will be able to give a good presentation. I can come to a conclusion that so Arjun will be able to give a good presentation. I am very much sure.
I think Arjun, I should supplement what sir said.
Yeah.
Your first question was, how can you judge a teacher 15 minutes? I think 15 submissions have sufficient time.
Yeah.
If you are a effective teacher, if you are a confident teacher, your audience will be able to judge, yes, I know what I got from you.
Yeah.
From within 10 minutes is more than sufficient. Now, result has nothing to do with being a good teacher. Right? It is a combined effort of the principal, teacher and the student.
Yeah, but individual effort of the teacher.
Yeah, individual effort of the teacher, individual effort of the student as well.
Yeah.
15 minutes is more than sufficient to judge a teacher. We know her pedagogy. That's all we wanted to know. We don't want to know other things. Like, how does she teach or how does the teaching learning process takes place in her class?
Yeah, I wanted to add your own example.
Yeah.
Mr. Narendra, mathematics teacher of Ibrahimpatnam, he gave a very good presentation, excellent presentation, and always his results are consistent 90% and above.
Yeah.
Narendra Ibrahimpatnam, who gave a presentation at Mahendrails, he gave a very good presentation with maths equipment. He gave a presentation. Everybody impressed with his presentation. When you compare his results also, always his results are very good, 90% and above. This is an example. Your own school presentation is an example.
Hello, I think we have another call coming up. Thank you, Arjuna, for your call. Hello.
Hello.
We have another call. Hello.
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 Yeah, hello.
Hello, sir.
Please ask the question.
Hello, sir. Myself Narendra Reddy.
Yeah, Narendra Reddy, good evening.
Yes, sir, good evening, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, I want to know what is the purpose of NQP, sir. First one.
Yeah.
is it to assess the teacher or to upgrade their knowledge or to improve their English?
Yeah, have
what
you
is
gone
the purpose of incubator?
Narendra Reddy, so I should ask you that question. Have you gone through the circular? Have you read the circular?
I want to know the purpose of incubator.
Okay. So it's the very purpose of the circular has been very clear. It's meant for the upgrading the skills of the teachers, and we have given the three parameters: the content knowledge of the teacher, the pedagogy, and the communicative skill. We wanted to check the teachers, and we wanted to upgrade themselves, and we wanted to give an opportunity to the teacher for giving presentations also.
Because I think I will add to what Lakshmi has said.
Yeah.
Even the studies and the survey also tells that if you listen and if you look at somebody, we will not improve. But the moment you started doing something,
yeah,
for example, you prepare for a seminar, you gather things, you gather information, you tend to improve your own skills. So it's a part of the study as well.
And also, we would like to, there are the best teachers, as I told with you. It's an opportunity. Observing the presentation skills of the other teachers also. The very positive part of this thing is the most of the experienced teachers while giving presentations, the juniors, they will learn from the best presentation of the our own teachers.
Yeah, it is not a fault finding exercise.
It's a kind of sharing the experience.
Yeah, it's only sharing the experience. Yes, hello, we have
another Narinder.
Hello.
I think it's a very good question you asked, Narendra Reddy sir. It's a very good question. I think we have one more. Hello? We have one more telephone. Hello?
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 Hello, we are able to hear you. Please continue.
Please ask the question, sir.
Hello?
Hello?
Hello? Sir, this is Ravindra Reddy from Isnapur.
Yeah, Ravindra Reddy from Isnapur.
Only.
Yeah. Okay.
The concept of this seminar is very good.
Very good. Yeah.
But is going on, sir, it is nothing but a classroom. It has become like a classroom observation.
Okay.
But the topics which we are communicating to the concerned teachers also to be not only from the textbook, from the textbook, what the teachers know, it is nothing but test to and it should not be evaluated. That's my personal opinion.
Yeah, I think your observation is very good. Your observation is good. It's a combination of everything.
Yeah. It's a kind of participate learning. Even we have seen the best teachers while giving presentations. Those are with the Telugu medium background, the resource teachers, the special teachers everywhere. So we are able to see and it's a kind of learning for us also. It's a kind of learning for us also.
Hello.
No, you can continue.
Hello.
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 Sir.
Yeah. Good evening.
I'm a teacher calling from Ara district, sir.
You okay?
Sir, I have questions about the newly introduced seminar sessions and the PPT sessions.
Okay.
Actually, the PPT that is introduced very latest is really very nice, and teachers are really getting ready to do their presentation through PPT.
Okay.
And the recent sessions, I find the teachers, the senior teachers are a little worried about these sessions because they are not used to giving seminars and not used to these PPT sessions, which they are not being able to do the presentation. PPT, how to make a PPT also many of the teachers are not known. So here they are really getting worried when they hear about the seminars and PPTs and not being able to come out properly when they are presenting it. What we really think is, sir, isn't there a need to train the teachers accordingly for a few days about the interactive sessions you're speaking about and the PPTs are newly learning and the seminars? Many times they are getting confused about these three things. What's the difference between a seminar and a PPT, all these things. And what I expect is maybe a 2 to 3 day seminar training class session to these senior teachers would be a great use.
You have a good observation, ma'am. I think you made a good observation, but I don't know why the teachers should get worried about PPT. We never find fault with the way of presentation. This is only trial and error method. Most of us learned computer by our own necessity, because we wanted to make a presentation, because we wanted to present a report, we learned it. So, not the first time, second time, third time, you are going to be all right. It is like a small baby trying to walk. Nobody teaches the baby to walk, or nobody teaches the squirrel to climb a tree. It's slowly and steadily you are going to learn it. Nothing wrong in that. It's only the first, somewhere you have to make a beginning. And I don't think a kind of training in PPT is required, because
I don't think so,
because it's not a professional thing, you know. By doing, you are going to perfect yourself. It's only part of the NQP.
Part of the seminar.
Yeah. It's only a teaching aid for you.
Yeah, I wanted to share with you, madam, this nearly 180 teachers, they have participated in the seminar. And out of this 180, for 100 of them, it is the first time experience that they are giving the PowerPoint presentations. And they are very confident after giving the presentation. So, even some practices, rehearsals, mock seminars, some of them they have conducted in the district, especially in Rangara district and even Medak also.
Some of them practice in the schools as well.
Yeah, they are practicing. Even sir has given permission for at least 1 week time for practicing itself.
Yeah, I hope the question.
So, we have got concern with your question, madam, but issue is, most of them, they successfully gave a presentation with the help of the PPT without much giving coaching for them or training for them.
I hope you are satisfied with the answer, though you have not mentioned your name. Okay, thank you. Next caller, please. Hello. Line is disconnected. Hello.
Good evening, sir. George sir and Lakshman sir. I am from the Narayan K JLPC Kashinath.
And Geeta Lakshmi madam also.
Good evening to the Geeta Lakshmi madam also.
Okay.
Good evening.
Sir.
Okay,
The seminar is excellent for the university level, but how it is performed to the in a school level students? For example, in mathematics and physics and chemistry, it is a derived part and the equation part. But only we are expressing the descriptive matter in a large manner. But it is not conceptual thinking, sir.
So, Kashinath, this PPT is not meant for all the 15 minutes or 20 minutes. You can take, it's only for 5 minutes. Wherever video clippings, certain photographs, activities required, you can take the help of the PPT only. So, there is no need of taking the PPT's help for the entire 15 minutes. It's only a teaching aid for you. Wherever that you cannot bring the entire this thing into the classroom, you can take the help of the PPT. Better videos are there, better clippings are there, the activities are there, you can present them. You can make it as a teaching aid to the for your presentation. Even nobody told that PPT should not be used in the classroom. It's only meant for the universities. Anyone can use the, even most of the classrooms in the schools are digital classrooms.
Yes, even the pre-primary classes, they use PPTs
to
show pictures,
to
show some illustrations.
Yeah.
As Lakshman sir said, you can also use some video clippings. It will be very effective.
Very effective.
Yeah. Hello, I hope you got the answer which you are waiting for.
Yeah, especially it's most useful for the physics teachers.
Physics teachers.
Especially,
I think we have one more for coming up. Hello.
Namaste, madam.
Namaste, Andy.
Hello.
Namaste. Please reduce the TV volume.
Hello, madam.
Hello. హలో
మేడం, నాకు తెలుగు విషయానికి వస్తే
చెప్పండి.
అయితే తెలుగులో వివిధ ప్రక్రియలు ఉంటాయి కదా మేడం?
అవును.
ఒక్కొక్క ప్రక్రియ మీద ప్రక్రియకి సంబంధించిన ఎక్స్పర్ట్లతో మనకు సెమినార్ ఇస్తే బాగా మంచి యూజ్ ఉంటుందని నేను అనుకుంటున్నా మేడం.
సబ్జెక్ట్ వైజ్ గా
వివిధ ప్రక్రియల మీద ఎక్స్పర్ట్లు, ప్రొఫెసర్లు ఒక్కొక్క సబ్జెక్ట్ లో ఒక్కొక్కరు ఎక్స్పర్ట్లు ఉంటారు కదా, వాళ్ళతో మాకు ఇప్పిస్తే దాంతో మాకు బాగా యూజ్ ఉంటుందని అనుకుంటున్నా మేడం.
అది కూడా చేయడానికి మేము రెడీగా ఉన్నాము, తప్పకుండా చేస్తాము.